you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This beautiful, this beautiful, this beautiful day. This beautiful, this beautiful, this beautiful day. Thank you for my friends, Spirit. Thank you for my friends. Thank you for my friends, Spirit. Thank you for my friends. My wonderful, my wonderful, my wonderful friends. My wonderful, my wonderful, my wonderful friends. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This beautiful, this beautiful. Everything is new today. Today's made of soft clay,
soft clay, soft clay.
And I can shape it my way,
my way, my way.
It's gonna be good, gonna be good, gonna be good. 'Cause everything is new today.
Hey, good morning, and welcome to the Center for Spiritual Living here in the heart of Las Cruces. I'm Reverend Bonnie, the community spiritual leader, and it's always my pleasure to welcome everyone. I can see the smiling eyes behind the masks. I love it. So I want to welcome you because our vision is a world in loving partnership for the good of all, and we're doing that whether we're in person or not. I would like to ask everyone to make sure their phones are on vibrate or off. And I would like to welcome anyone who's here for the first time. We have welcome packets on the back tables that you can help yourself to on the way out. Someday we'll start handing you things again, but right now we're not touching and handing. And this is a friendly reminder that at 10:15 we have meditation in here. The practitioner in service does the meditation from 10:15 to 10:35. So you're welcome to join us a little early for a beautiful meditation in this space. And aside from our Sunday celebrations, we do have a few things that are starting up here at the center. Saturdays, starting August 28th, from 1 to 2, Ray Kleitz will be teaching Tai Chi in this room, and it is free to members. So if you're a member, that's one of the benefits that you get. You can take his class for free. And we have a hybrid class that will be starting up, Power of Your Word, on Thursdays. September 9th will be the first Thursday from 5:30 to 8:30. Hybrid meaning you can Zoom in or you can be here in person. Jennifer and I will be teaching that class together, so call the office if you're interested. And we are starting up the Spiritual Circle discussions again at a new day and time. Thursdays from 1:30 to 2:30, again, hybrid. I will be in the building or you can Zoom in. And Jim Rogers is still co-facilitating that with me and he will be Zooming. So if you would like to join us for discussions from the Science of Mind magazine and from what you've heard on Sundays, we can have those discussions at that time. And sadly, given what's going on in the world around us, our board and I decided that some of the events that we were planning will not be happening. The pop-up prom has been postponed. Hopefully in the spring, if things look better, we will dance in each other's presence, but we didn't think that'd be the greatest idea right now. And our Spanish-speaking foundations class has also been postponed, hopefully till spring. And our auction that we were hoping to have in November has also been postponed. So stay tuned for those. We'll see when we can have bigger groups coming together. So continue to check out our website, pick up the monthly calendar that are on the back tables, and especially the website to keep up with what's going on, and be sure to read your newsletter. If you don't get our newsletter, let us know in the office and we can get you on as long as you have email. And so now I would like to invite up our wonderful board president and practitioner in service, Bob Greer.
It's two for one day. You get the board president and the practitioner all in the same person. So it's great to be here. I have a few announcements from our last board meeting and to keep everybody up to speed with what's going on with our center. So yesterday or Friday, we had a little excitement here for those of you that haven't heard about it already, which so I'm sure the word has gotten out a little bit. While Reverend Bonnie and Judy were having a meeting in the office in there, some young man decided that he wanted to come into the building, and he went around first and rang the doorbell, and by the time they got over there, he was walking away, and they didn't think anything about it. But the problem is he walked away, and he turned around, and he came back to the back of the building here where we have there's a couple of glass doors, one to Reverend Bonnie's office, and the other one goes into the back here, and he picked up a rock and broke the window and crawled inside, which I was surprised because it was only a hole about like that, and commenced to rifle through these offices back here, the one that now Unity uses, and our records room over here. And luckily, somebody pulled up and said, by the way, do you know there's a broken door back here? No. And Reverend Bonnie and Judy didn't hear. So they were in that side. He was over here. And luckily, she's had training, and hats off to Reverend Bonnie. The first thing she did is grabbed a couple of metal brooms and mops and stuck them through the door handles there. So that separates that side of the building from this side. And he wasn't in here very long, but he managed to make a mess in a couple of offices. I called Randy. He came down because I was afraid he would have taken some of this expensive gear over here. But apparently the only thing he stole was Randy's gloves. Kind of weird. Need some new ones anyway.
Yeah, they were getting old.
And so they called the police, obviously, and they came down and made sure everything was all right. And, yeah, it's scary and it's a little, you know. But all in all, it was okay. It could have been worse. And we didn't lose anything, at least not that we have discovered at this point. I was able to contact our local glass company down here, Arts Glass, who we've used before, and they sent a crew over right away and put a new piece of glass in the door. And now this one, the old one was probably the original glass from when the building was built, and it was plate. And it just broke. You know, it was thick, but, you know, it broke open like a window glass. But now we have laminated safety, you know, it's going to slow people down. And I think that's the last door that doesn't have that. So hopefully that'll slow anybody down that tries to do that in the future. And we'll just hold that this gentleman gets the help that he needs and that he doesn't go after anybody else. So anyway, we felt that it was important to talk and let everybody know so that it's not a, you know, I mean, it's not the way we want to start our Sunday, but, you know, it needs to be told. And so the overall cost was $600 for a new piece of glass, and we have the money to do that, so I'm grateful for that. On a better note, our roof has finally been repaired. We're 99% sure. We've been working with the contractors from Boudicker Company, who is the contractor that installed the cell tower for Verizon, and they are picking up the cost of everything, and they completely redid the inside of the tower enclosure. And did find a couple of holes on the inside there that we think could have been contributing to what's happening over here. And they also redid the drain. There's a roof drain right near there that they found that it had a little separation in the membrane, so they fixed that. And then they water tested it, where they actually put a hose up there into that area and filled it full of water, and we stood down here and watched and never saw anything. So we feel really confident that it's fixed. They will hopefully be back next week to replace all the tiles in that area over there and make it look nice again. And we're grateful for that it, you know, we've been wrestling with this for a long time, and we finally feel that that we got a handle on it. And Congrats to the guys at Roof Care. That was their roofer of choice, and they seem to be a stand-up bunch of guys, so I was grateful for that. As Reverend Bonnie mentioned, the pop-up prom was canceled or postponed, and we're disappointed by that, but we felt, the board felt that, we just need to proceed cautiously as we go through this next phase of this next phase. And so we're going to keep the masking policy in place, obviously, but we are going to continue with our Sunday services live. So we did affirm that. So for now, at least, I'm one of the people that I like, I like this, I look forward to it. So for those of you that are comfortable attending, please know that we'll, for the foreseeable future, we'll be doing that. And also on that same note, we are still continuing to work on being able to eventually get to the point where we can live stream this to YouTube and Facebook, working with Randy Brown over here. And but we will continue to record and post those onto YouTube. And thank you very much for all you do, both of you. It's amazing. I tell people all the time, the center I used to be at, we had a sound guy, a video guy, the band, and we have all of that in him. And he does it all at the same time, which is pretty. And then he goes home and works like a Trojan for 24 hours to get the thing ready to be posted onto YouTube. So it's a big, big contributing part here. We thank you. We also discovered that we used to have a sound guy here we kept going through sound guys for a while. And so Randy just bought some of his own equipment and rigged it up so that he's able to control everything from right there. Now we don't have to have a sound person anymore. And it dawned on us that he's taken on this extra responsibility, and we have the money already allocated to pay a sound person. So it only made sense that we'll pass that money on to Randy, and we're grateful to be able to do it. And he was doing this without even saying anything, and it just it took us a while to figure it out. But
and I very much appreciate it.
We'll be very grateful. So, and I don't know if we talked about this, but I want to mention it anyway. This last weekend, we had this wonderful celebration at Doug and Tina Bailey's house for our new practitioners. And we all met and had a nice little ceremony and a little nosh afterwards, and it was a beautiful day. And we were able to grab a whole new picture of our 11 practitioners all in the same place. So we have posted that to the website. And so if you haven't been to the website lately, go check it out. I think it's a great shot, and we're grateful to have our three new practitioners added to the core here. And we're constantly adding little bits and pieces to the website, and I think it's coming along nicely. But if anybody sees anything or thinks, hey, it'd be nice to have this or that, please reach out to me, let me know, or the office, and we will certainly look into it. So many people these days, everything they do is web-based, and so we're trying to keep that up and fresh and current. I also want to let you know that because of the loving support we receive from our congregation, we're doing well financially. During the time that we were not meeting in person, we had to dip into some of the funds that we got as part of our grant to make ends meet. And I'm happy to say that for the last 3 months since we've started meeting again, we've been able to clear our expenses without having to dip into any of that. And we're very, very grateful for that. I want to thank you all for your continued contributions of tithe and offerings. And we have a couple of outside events planned in the future here that will hopefully bring in a little extra money. We, during the time we were shut down, we didn't have any of that. And that makes up a chunk of what we bring in every year. And so we're looking to, have more and more of those and make this space available to the groups that need it. I will also mention that just in passing, for those of you that are like me that like to do electronic things, You know, you can make your tithes and offerings now either through an app called Zelle, which a lot of the banks support, or, you know, most banks have a bill pay section where you can set up a regular automatic transfer. It takes a few days, but it works just fine, and that way you don't have to worry about it. Everything I do is pretty much that way these days because I can't remember to check anything. So anyway, with that, that's my report. Okay, here. 2 for 1. My name is Bob Greer. I'm your practitioner on duty today. We believe in the power of prayer, which we call spiritual mind treatment or affirmative prayer. Prayer request forms can be found in the pockets in the back of the chairs and are also on the table back there next to the little prayer chest where you can deposit your prayer request, or you can also put them in the offering plate as you leave today, either over there or over there. And as I mentioned, our website, we have a 24, anytime, day or night, you would like a prayer request, you can go to our website, fill it out right online. Those are sent anonymously to a practitioner only, and nobody else sees them. And then they're passed along to the prayer team, which is made up of the New Thought, the four local New Thought communities that serve in Las Cruces, and we meet every Tuesday afternoon, and we take all of those into prayer. And also, should anyone feel the need for a quick treatment after service today, just find, looks like me and Geneva are here today, so we'd be happy to offer you that service, and it's our pleasure always. So now it's time for a song, silence, and prayer.
In this moment, I am heard. Heard is this moment. This moment is what I am. In this moment, I am truth. Truth is this moment. Truth.
So just opening to this moment right here, right now, this perfect moment, knowing that the full power and presence of Spirit is right here, right now, in and through everyone present and everyone at all times. Knowing that everything that happens in this moment is perfect and divinely guided, I simply bless this service, knowing that everything that needs to be said is said, everything that needs to be heard is heard. So grateful for this opportunity to be able to gather together here and to share in this wonderful teaching. So I simply say, and so it is. So for today, this is kind of funny, I did a little search under the title A Pause for Guidance. And I found an email that had been sent out to me last year sometime from Science of Mind Archives that had an excerpt of an article that was written by our founder, Ernest Holmes, in the Science of Mind magazine in January of 1945. That was way before I was here. Well, not way, but a little bit. Anyway, and he says, "We are immersed in an infinite sea of intelligence which instantly knows the answer to any problem, not because it enters into contemplation of the problem, since principles have no problems, but because it instantly knows the answer to any problem. When we ask for divine guidance, we are really bringing our problem to a principle which has no problems. If we can get away from a problem long enough, we shall find the answer. When the mind turns to the divine for a solution to its problems, the divine, being ever present, answers by intuitively knowing not the problem, but its solution." And so it is.
Sometimes I feel the fear of uncertainty stinging clear, and I can't help but ask myself how much I'll let the fear take the wheel and steer. It's driven me before, and it seems to have a faint haunting mass appeal, but lately I'm beginning to find that where I should be the one behind the wheel. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be decide to waver my chance to be one of the hive. Will I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive? Oh, oh, oh. It's driven me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. Lately, I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there, I'll be there. Would you choose water over wine? Hold the wheel and drive. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there, I'll be there. Do-do-do-do-do.
Do-do-do-do-do-do.
Thank you. So one of our faves today, Reverend Randy Granger, who is an ordained minister with the Universal Life Seminaries, a motivational speaker, educator, workshop leader, professional musician, and licensed massage therapist. He's also a good cook. Of Native American ancestry, Randy lives right here in Las Cruces, New Mexico, and he practices science of mind, teaching Zen meditation and sound healing. Please help me welcome Reverend Randy Granger.
Good morning. I do love to cook because I love to eat. Wow. Thank you for that song. That was kind of cool to hear the wooka wooka wooka. Some scratching in the CSL downtown. Word. Just a quick note. I had a couple of COVID scares recently. People who I'd spent time with who were vaccinated, they had tested positive. Their grandchildren infected them. They couldn't help that. But so I got tested. Of course, I'm negative. Thank goodness. But out of consideration to all of you and to the people in my care, instead of shaking hands or hugging, this is how I greet people now. I put my hand on my heart to let you know that my heart meets your heart. So I have a confession to make. I hear voices. You all do, right? Don't you? Two cars ago and two GPS units ago, I was on tour somewhere. I don't even remember where exactly, but it seems I was kind of lost, and I think that my GPS unit was also lost too. So when I had some time, I pulled over and I thought, and I tried to plug in coordinates and tried to plug in all this different stuff. So then I started back up and I got in my car and I'm driving along to my next gig, and my GPS voice. This woman's voice, out of nowhere, she says something like, I don't remember the exact word, but she said something like, "Are you sure you're on the right path?" I swear there was some judgment in that tone. So I'm like, I never heard that. And I said, "What?" You know, she never said it again, you know, for as long as I had. So, but that got me thinking. You know, I'm driving along and I'm thinking, well, what does that mean? Am I on the right path? You know, here I'm driving around the country, spending 2 hours a day making music, and then the rest of the time looking for a place to sleep. And I thought, you know, maybe I'm not on the right path. But it got me thinking, when we talk about guidance, we should also be asking who's doing the guiding and who's doing the driving. So I'm going to talk about that today, because our theme for this whole month with the CSLs is pause for guidance. I'm of Native American ancestry, as Bonnie mentioned, and so basically I see guidance everywhere. I mean, especially in nature, like if I see a raven or a snake or a coyote on the road, and don't even get me started about hearing or seeing an owl. You know, we basically run the other way. And just the other morning, I was out walking in my neighborhood, and I try to walk about 5:30 in the morning before it gets too hot. And I felt something staring at me, and I looked, and it was a black cat just staring at me, sitting there. And then I was walking along, and I saw this hawk on the top of this dead pine tree going, you know, calling me. And then I got home. I was listening to this meditation that was specifically, I thought, tailored for me. Now, what did all these signs mean? I have no idea. But they meant something, I was sure. So my dreams are so filled with signs and messages, I could do a Netflix series, I'm telling you. I'm guided by intuition constantly, as we all are, every moment of every day that I'm doing something. And when I don't give attention to that intuition, that's when I usually end up suffering or having some kind of pain. So I do want to talk about that, but I have so many examples for you. It was a hard time trying to decide which one to give for you, so I asked for guidance on that. And this is the one I'm going to tell you. This is 2021, right? Okay, I can't even. My checks are 1991, so I still write checks, Bob. So you know. But it was 10 years ago this year that my late partner passed at my home where I am now. It had been a really rough ride going back to MD Anderson Cancer Center over in Houston and back. Chemotherapy, finding and buying a new home, prepping the current home for sale, having to cancel all of my tours and promotions and become a full-time caregiver. Pretty much all the major stressors of life in 1 year. But days after he passed, I was a complete mess, of course. And all the stress and grief that just waylaid me. And I felt really unable physically and emotionally to, and spiritually, move on from that grief. And I'd been desperately praying for guidance from Spirit and from God. I just really needed some kind of sign. And so one afternoon, I was sitting there, and my doorbell rang. And there were these big knocks on my door. And I eventually got up to answer the door. And it was my snowbird next-door neighbor, demanding to know why my friends and I were on his roof this past weekend. I told him, go away, I don't even have a ladder. And I was just not in a space to deal with him. And he just went on saying that me and my friends were partying up on his roof and that he climbed his rickety ladder. He was 80 at the time, and he climbed his roof with a big stick. He's gonna let us have it. And I had some choice words for him. And then I said, hey, Who told you I was on your roof, you know? And he said, it was Connie, who lives across the cul-de-sac from me. And he said that she saw people on his roof, me and my friends, and she had called him. And he said, but she may have been drinking that banana liqueur we bought her in Jamaica. And so I said, give me her phone number, okay? And so I just went for a walk because I really needed to calm down and get some perspective on what was going on. I affirmed over and over something I'd learned through the science of mind, you know, is I am guided and guarded by God's love alone and all is well. I just kept saying that and asking for some guidance. So by the time that I came home, I was still kind of worked up a little bit, but I walked through the front door and out of habit, I looked to the bedroom where he had been through the whole cancer stuff. And then all of a sudden, all that guidance that I've been praying for, well, it paid off. Because I realized suddenly, oh, that was him on the roof. I live in a townhome and we share walls. The bedroom is right next to their wall. And I thought, that was him. That was him up on the wall, up on the roof. So I called Connie and I said, hey Connie, this is Randy. She had never met my partner, didn't even know I had a partner, but I had met her once at her garage sale. And so I said, can you describe these people on the roof? And she said, well, it was just one guy. And she said, he was wearing this and he was tall. And I said, now what shirt was he wearing? And she said, and I said, what pants was he wearing? And the thing is that no one but me knew the clothes that I had put him in. And no one saw it because they wheeled him out in a blue velvet mortuary, funeral home bag. So of course, no one even saw him, and it was zippered up. So I knew without a doubt that it was him because the last poem he was working on was called "Dancing on the Roof," and so I was like, oh, and then I just collapsed. I collapsed in gratitude. I collapsed in thankfulness that I could have. I guess that was the sign I was looking for. And Connie said, he was going up and down like that man from The Music Man, that drum leader from The Music Man. And I said, oh, he was finally able to use his legs that he hadn't been able to use for the last month. So wow, that was a time when, you know, guidance paid off. Viktor Frankl, he famously wrote, between stimulus and response, there is a space. And in that space is our power to choose our response. And in our response lies our growth and our freedom. The space, that space that's between the experience and the response is really where the guidance is. It's the same space that's between the footfalls of a mountain climber, the space between breaths, the rest between heartbeats. There's a pause for growth in nature. Just think about it, between sowing and growing, blossom and fruit, between the seasons, between conception and birth, gestation and maturity. when your 35-year-old son finally leaves the house. And just kidding. But humans, we're impatient when it comes to guidance. Yep, we want spiritual guidance to be like Google guidance, you know. Hey, Siri, I'm wanting to make a major life decision. What should I do? Siri will answer you the way my GPS did. Are you sure you're on the right path? What do you know? When we pause for guidance, it's a process of divine time. So how do we discern this guidance? Carl Jung said, there is a deep need in the world just now for guidance, almost any sort of spiritual guidance. And Chief Ponca, White Eagle, he lived sometime in the 1800s, and he was reported to have said, when you're in doubt, be still and wait. When doubt no longer exists for you, then go forward with courage. So long as mists envelop you, be still. Be still until the sunlight pours through and dispels the mists, as it surely will, and then act with courage. Now, to me, this verse seems almost like meditation. He's saying, sit in silence. And when the clouds exist in our mind, we have no way of knowing what the right action is to take. When we act during these moments such as these, it can lead to trouble and suffering, as I mentioned. Clarity in life is what's really priceless. As without it, you're flying blind and you're subject to the winds of change. It's wise to devote a part of life, cultivating and maintaining clarity if you can, as this itself will certainly lead to peace and happiness. And when you get there, don't hesitate. Know that you have the truth within you, like Bob's reading, and know that you're right and that what you're doing is good. Stand up, move forward, and act with courage. What are some times in life that we might need spiritual guidance? Anybody? Every day. To answer our prayers, maybe? To help us make decisions? To gain clarity, to help us create new things, to detour us off in the right direction, to offer love and support and peace? I don't know about you guys, but I definitely have needed guidance every single day through this entire time. And I'm certainly humble enough to say, when I'm on my walks, I always ask, can I have clarity? Can I have guidance? So what's the process to know when this guidance is happening? Well, the first, of course, is to ask. You know, the way that you ask advice from medical professionals, attorneys or friends, accountants, mechanics, plumbers, roofers. Spirit responds to our call when we ask. When asking for guidance, I always like to include, in divine time, divine will be done in the best way for the highest good of all. It's that all-encompassing insurance policy. The next step is to pause. Just let it rest in assurance that all the knowledge and all the wisdom ever known is acting on our behalf. I like to invite my guides, the best of my ancestors, ascended teachers, to help me. Surrender is the next step. Surrender because there's nothing more important than getting out of our own way. Ego will fight you every step of the way because it needs us to think that ego is in control and can fix everything by showing you whose fault it is. Just say to ego, hello there. Nice to see you. Now go in love. Yeah. The next is to be in attention. What that means is that guidance doesn't come the way that we want it, does it? It comes the way that we need it to. So it can be subtle or dramatic, like in my example of my partner dancing on the roof. Keep notes, journal, connect the synchronicities and coincidences. Always be aware and open for them. And feel those gut feelings, those nudges, those intuitive hits, which come from a program or a book or an article or a talk or a conversation with people that you know, or even conversations that you overhear. That's where I get most of my best song ideas. Be open and spend time in nature as much as possible, because the closer we are to appreciation and joy, the other feelings that are high up on the emotional guidance scale, the more receptive and in tune that we will be. It's like we're tuning that radio station, tuning that antenna. I like this meditation that Ernest Holmes has in the The Art of Life. And if you don't have The Art of Life, I definitely recommend that. It's just a beautiful, beautiful companion book. He says, I know that God is within me. I know that the Spirit within me is perfect, and I enter into its peace and am secure in its protection. The unerring judgment of divine intelligence directs my way. There's another way to be receptive to guidance. It's a technique called the appreciation game. And if you've never heard of it, it's a real playful way to look for guidance, to invite guidance. Because, like I said, the higher up on the emotional guidance scale we are, the more receptive that we will be to our own guidance, our inner guidance. So when you find yourself feeling stuck, or you're negative, or you're anxious, or a situation about life that's out of control, stressed out over news, life, or just in a really bad mood, then play the appreciation game. The way you do it is you say to yourself out loud, if you can, express appreciation for all the good in your life. And you might say things like, I appreciate all the people who are supporting me. I appreciate the love that's in my life. I appreciate the home I have. I appreciate the shoes on my feet. I appreciate the meal on this table in front of me. I appreciate my community, this land, my abundance. Going down that list every day, or even several times throughout the day, is a fastest way I have found to get out of a negative pattern or a fear-based story that we keep telling ourselves. As we move up that emotional guidance scale, you become magnetic. You become magnetic to those signs of guidance, to those coincidences, to those synchronicities. Now, if you're having some trouble with that, well, just do a simple meditation on God or divine spirit or love, or affirmations like, I am at peace with the world in which I live. I am at home in the divine spirit in which I am immersed. I say that all day. I sometimes ask, what is my next best step? What wisdom is my soul seeking here that allows me to get out of the way? So we really have to keep in mind that we're always being guided. I mean, we're always being guided. At the grocery store, you're being guided, right? You know, should I get those cookies or some blueberries? Cookies. Blueberry cookies. But we're always being guided. Even when we're dreaming, we're being guided. Every night before I go to bed, this is what I say. I say, first of all, I wrap myself in a blanket of love. I withdraw all the connections that I've had throughout the day with anyone and with everything. And I say, if any of my ancestors or guides has a message for me tonight in my dreams, please bring it to me in a way that I can understand. Last night, I didn't do that. And I dreamt I was in some house where I had cleaned up their kitchen, and they came in and they took all the trash out and said, you're supposed to separate all the compost from the, I don't know what that was about. So. But that's what I try to remember to do every night. Now, we might call this guidance, we might call it other names like knowledge or wisdom or understanding or insight or intuition, but it's important to cultivate them all. And the more that we practice them, they become like muscle memory, like when a musician or a tennis player practices all the time. It's just automatic. In short, you have to know and you have to learn in order to gain knowledge. And you have to make a knowledgeable choice to gain wisdom. You have to practice that choice to gain understanding, and finally, practice that choice consistently to gain insight, and then act on intuition. There's a writer and a mystic and a seer named Anton St. Martin, and he writes, intuition goes before you, showing you the way. Emotions follow behind to let you know when you go astray. Listen to your own inner voice. It is the calling of your spiritual GPS system, seeking to keep you on track towards your true destiny. So as you go through this next week, look for signs, look for the intuitions, look for when a song comes on, look for when you're hitting all the green lights, look for when you're hitting all the yellow lights, look for all the red lights. These intuitive hits are constantly working for us and guiding us. So just be in attention. I'd like to end with a beautiful Native American prayer that really sums it all up for me, because this whole guidance thing is nothing new. We've been, you know, we've been using guidance since we were reading tea leaves, reading coffee grounds, the oracles at Delphi. But we have our own internal GPS. And hopefully, you know, it'll say to you, you are on the right path. So this is a Native American wisdom here. It says, let me walk in beauty and make my eyes ever behold the red and purple sunset. Make my hands respect the things you have made and my ears sharp to hear your voice. Make me wise so that I may understand the things you have taught my people. Let me learn the lessons you have hidden in every leaf and every rock. I seek strength not to be greater than my brother, but to fight my greatest enemy, myself. Make me always ready to come to you with clean hands and straight eyes, so that when life fades, as the fading sunset, my spirit may come to you without shame. And so it is. Thank you.
When I'm lost in the rain, in your eyes I know I'll find the light to light my way. When I'm scared, losing ground, when my world is going crazy, you can turn it all around. And when I'm down, you're there pushing me to the top. You're always there giving me all you got. For a shield from the storm, for a friend, for a love to keep me safe and warm. I turn to you for the strength to be strong, for the will to carry on. For everything you do, for everything that's true, I turn to you. When I lose the will to win, I just reach for you and I can reach the sky up. I can do anything, 'cause your love is so amazing, 'cause your love inspires me. When I need a friend, you're always on my side, giving me faith, taking me through the night. For a shield from the storm, for a friend, for a love to keep me safe and warm. I turn to you for the strength to be strong, for the will to carry on. For everything you do, I turn to you. For the arms to be my shelter through all the rain, for truth that will never change, for someone to lean on, for a heart I can rely on through anything, for the one who I can run to. For a shield from the storm, for a friend, for a love to keep me safe and warm. I turn to you for the strength to be strong, for the will to carry on. For everything you do, for everything that's true, for everything you do, for everything that's true, I turn to you.
Was a beautiful prayer in and of itself. Thank you, Mary Lynn. And I have to tell you, I haven't sat right in front of that speaker. That was beautiful. It was like she was right in my head singing. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you. And thank you, Randy, for a wonderful talk and great reminders of how it is we listen to that divine guidance. And so now is our opportunity to consider giving and continuing to support the center. Like Bob said, I am so grateful for the support we've had throughout this year and that we continue to have. We've only had to dip into the support reserves a little bit each month, and for the most part, our continued giving has been what supported us. So the opportunity is still there. We have plates at either door. Again, we're not passing things hand to hand yet. So this month, we are tithing 10% of what comes in, and I am so proud to say and grateful, because it's our spiritual teaching, that we have tithed throughout this entire year as well on everything that's come through this door, everything. All of those grants, so people got some good from what we got as well. So this month, we are giving to Desert Hope Apartments. Desert Hope Apartments is an affordable housing partnership that began in 2017 with the Mesilla Valley Housing Authority, Mesilla Valley Community of Hope, and the City of Las Cruces. It has resulted in the transformation of a rundown building with 40 efficiency apartments. It is a picture of hope and a home for people experiencing chronic homelessness in the Las Cruces area. So 10% of what comes through this month has been going to support them, as we are supporting people to move from that experience of homelessness to their own apartment and eventually out beyond this apartment to their own in the world. So let's just recognize the divine spirit that supports us by repeating after me. Divine love through me, blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. Thank you, God, in me. And so it is. And so you can either sing in your own heads or silently behind your mask, I am so blessed.
We are so blessed. We are so blessed. We are so grateful for all that we have. We are so blessed. We are so blessed. We are so grateful. We are so blessed. We are so blessed. We are so blessed. We are so grateful for all that we have. We are so blessed. We are so blessed. We are so grateful. We are so
for one, I feel very blessed by this community and this teaching and each and every one of you. So thank you for being here. And today we will be having a new member orientation if anyone is interested in joining us who hasn't joined us yet. At 12:30 or maybe even 12:15, let me know and we'll meet in my office and I'll put you through that little orientation. That being said, let's just stand and join each other in our closing song. Just send that energy around. We're not holding hands yet. So just send that energy around to each other.
I leave here in peace. I step out in love. I know everything I need is part of me, and I will not speak until I first think, is it kind and true and needed? One life, God's life, my life now.
until at first thing. Is it kind and true, Anita? Why?